Hey guys, this is Kevin. I'm here with Abby. We still work from the lab, so there will be some noise in the background. Okay, Abby, take it away.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. I was working on this printer, and I was going through my cleaning procedures, working on cleaning the print head, and I had gotten to day 3 when I found out that the print head was no good. I decided to switch it to another print head to try to work on this printer to get ready to sell, and it came up with a 0x9A error. Told me that it could be a mainboard error, it could be a print head error, and I looked at my FFC cables for where my print head goes, and one of them was not looking the best. It had looked like it had been burnt, probably from when we had done so many cleanings. So I decided that we were gonna try to change out the FFC cables. Along with talking with Kevin, we decided that we were gonna change up the cleaning procedure here a bit after this. So here I am taking off the cover to the frame, and here I am gonna, I'll show you where that FFC cable wasn't looking the best. There on the bottom, that bottom pin looks a bit burnt.
Hey my fellow YouTubers, thank you for subscribing to my channel. Here's a coupon to help you on your next project. The coupon is only valid for 24 hours after the video is released. You can use the coupon on anything at bchtechnology.com, a website designed by makers for the makers. We have printer parts, scientific medical ink. You can learn how to make your own ink, and DTF, sublimation edible ink. Here you get all kinds of sources for how to modify your printer. We even have stamp ink. Here's so old surface ink, and you can stamp on any kind of surface except water. You can stamp on glass, vinyl, anything, even our congressman. If you need more coupons in the future, please subscribe to my channel and make sure you turn the bell on so you won't miss the new videos and surprise coupons.
Once I got the FFC cable off of the main board, that's when I worked on unscrewing the 3 screws that hold the bottom rail down. Then you can work on taking the FFC bundle from that bottom rail. I had to use like a little needle to work on taking that back FFC cable, the thin one, from the back of that printhead frame.
We'll do this, just make sure that you do not twist it or damage the clear cable in the back.
This is where I wanted to show again, that on that far right side, that pin was pretty burnt.
I have a video about how to repair this FFC cable. I'm going to post the link here. And also, if you just need a new one, you can go to bchtechnology.com and go to printer parts. Go to Epson under the electronic board and assembly. And on the left side, you can see FFC flex cables. Here, this is the cable that Abby is talking about.
So this is a printer that I was taking apart for parts, and I had decided that I was just going to use these FFC cables and replace it in the other printer. So I'm going to work on taking off that bottom rail again and taking off this bundle of FFC cables and replacing it with the other one.
Oh, before we go any further, if you do know how to take the case off and the scanner off, I'm going to put a link to the video above.
As I was doing all of this, I tried to keep the FFC cable bundles. I tried to keep it mostly in the same orientation, just that way. And when I say orientation, I mean the FFC bundle has this little like double-sided glue or double-sided tape that holds it together. So I tried not to pull that apart when I took it out and switched it over into this side. That way it's still kind of all held together. So here I am working on putting in those 3 FFC cables. And if you're wondering what side, just look for the side that has that iron core piece. You'll put that side into the main board. And then work on putting the other side through that small hole, feeding it through into that frame that holds the print head.
It is possible if you do not be careful enough, you may be able to tear the FFC cable. So when you put it in and out, just make sure you don't tear it.
Here I am working to try to get these cables to fit right. There's this little clip on the right side of that frame. You can kind of fit the cables nicely into there and it'll help hold it. Here I'm putting the print head back in. You flip it upside down and these either side cables will fit in there nicely. And here I am trying to push those side cables back into that kind of clip on that side that I was talking about. Here I'm just going to screw down. There'll be three screws that you can put into that will help hold that print head in place. And then there'll be another cover that sits on top of that. Then you're going to take this other FFC cable and put it into this other piece that will then fit down into that middle-ish piece that sits on the top of that print head. If you have trouble wondering which way to put that print head in, the piece that I'm putting on now, if you look at it, it tells you which way the colors go. So just line up your print head to match the same way as that piece does. Here I am putting in the ink cartridges and putting that cover back on. And then I'll just go ahead and work on putting my side pieces back on, my side cover pieces back on. And then I'll just go ahead and put the screws to hold them back in place. Then we'll work on putting on the LCD panel. Go ahead and put the FFC cables in and the ground wire, the other wire, and then we can put two screws in on either side of the LCD panel to hold it in place. Once I got that cover on, I can go ahead and put the seven screws in there and put that hinge back in. You want to make sure you put that hinge in and screw that hinge down on, and so it helps hold the scanner in place. Then we can go ahead and get the scanner and work on putting the scanner back on, feeding the FFC cable and the other wires back through. Once it fits on, then we can work on making sure the wires match up to the corresponding place.
If you need instructions about how to put those scanner wires back, you can click the link above, which leads you to a flow sheet. In the flow sheet, there are pictures where about where the wires are and the color of the wire and the connection colors.
Once I have all my wires plugged in, I want to take my wires and try to tuck them in nicely to make sure that my fax cover can fit on. And it does. So I'll go ahead and turn my printer back around, and I'm going to want to go ahead and screw on that fax cover. By this point, I'm going to go ahead and put on the duplexer and the waste tank back in. I'm going to put power back on the printer. It does come up with a 0x9A error still, so at this point, that's when we might want to go ahead and try changing out the main board. I can make another video showing how to change the main board. Like I said, Kevin and I had discussed about changing the cleaning procedure, which we are changing it, and hopefully that will cut down on the 0x9A errors when I have to change the print head. So let us know if you want to see another video on how to change the main board.
Okay, sorry, we still end up with a 0x9A. I'll put another video that Abby changed the motherboard. It turned out that it's the main board, it's not the wire. But I hope this video can help you to figure out how to change your cables. And this cable was bad anyway, so you have to change it. Anyway, I hope this video is helpful for you. And please visit us at www.bchtechnologies.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.